Hey guys, what's going on? Today I want to talk to you about a couple new blushes that I picked up. I picked up the Tarte Amazonian Clay blushes. Let me just grab them over here. I picked up the Tarte Amazonian Clay blushes in Exposed and Sensual. I was between Risqué and Exposed, but I decided to go ahead and pick up Exposed because it's more of like that pinky nude color, and the Sensual color is more of that like peachy color, and the Risqué was along the same like peachy color, so I thought I'd pick up kind of two different blushes. And the reason I picked these up is because I always have an issue with blush staying on my face. That is the first thing to come off, probably because I do this a lot, and the first thing I touch is usually my cheeks. Streets of Chicago, there's a police car going down the street. I don't know if you could hear that. So yeah, I wanted to get something that does actually claim to be a little more long wearing, and I know the Tarte blushes are really hyped up, so I thought I'd try it on here with you. I have the Wet n Wild Nudist Peach color on my lips right now, and I feel like it looks a little bit patchy. I know I said when I first did this video that this one does take a couple of layers, and I feel like today it looks pretty patchy, so you guys let me know what you think about that. But I felt like the sun's finally out in Chicago. It's gonna be like 75 degrees this weekend, so I was feeling kinda like I needed to bring out the peaches, the summer color. So let's go in with Sensual today. I'll swatch both of them on the back of my hand. I picked these up again at the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty sale, so they were $14, usually $28. I thought that was a really good deal to give these a try. That I've bought like 7 things from the 21 Days of Beauty. I like can't get enough of it. Today I bought the Anastasia brow pencil because again it's like half off, and actually I think it might even be more than half. No, I think it's half off. And I hated that brow pencil when I had it a couple years ago, so I'm hoping I like it more. So finally got those out of there. I feel like I just worked up a sweat doing that. Oh, by the way, I got my hair colored and cut. I did like, back up here, I did like a really blunt cut at the ends. I cut off 3 inches. I can't believe I did that. But the ends of my hair was like super dead, so did that. Colored the hair a little bit. So yeah, that's what's going on with my hair today. So to start, Exposed is in this hand and Sensual is in this hand. So you can see the difference in color. I try to cover my face so it focuses on the blushes and not my face. So Exposed right here is more of a pinky nude color, and Sensual is more of like a peachy nude color. So I think today we'll go in with Sensual, but let me swatch both of them really quick. They feel a lot better in the new pan that I have than they did in store. I think the ones in store had been swatched so many times. They were like really, really, really rough and did not swatch very well. I don't know if that's because they were dried out, which kind of makes me nervous. Will these like get that way once I have them for a while? I don't know. So Exposed is on the top right here, and Sensual is down here. I really like both these colors a lot, actually. And in my opinion, Risqué was kind of like a mix of both of them, which is why I decided to get these two. I could kind of mix them. So let me throw my hair back here. Whoa, what is that? See what happens when you have hooded eyes? Sorry, guys. We'll just have to deal with it. This is real life, people. So yeah, let's go in with Sensual. I'm gonna take it on this Wet n Wild little blush brush here. It's a pretty color. I obviously applied a lot there. I wanna blend it out a little bit. I like to like apply my blush a little bit heavier and then blend it out. Pretty, I like it. It's just a peachy nude. Hopefully you guys can see. I'm sure you guys can see that, not hopefully. I kinda hate when people say that. Hopefully you guys can see it, like you should be able to see it. Should I do Exposed on the other side just so you guys could see it? And just look a little crazy. Yeah, let's go ahead and just do exposed on the other side so you guys can see what that looks like. Honestly, they're not even that different. Like when I'm looking at myself like this, this is a little more pinky than this one, obviously, but not a huge difference. And I'm not like a huge blush person. Like I don't dig my brush into my pan and then apply it. Sheila, my friend kind of does that. She loves blush. So that's what that looks like exposed on this side. And sensual on this side. I like them so far. Now, the whole thing here is going to be how they wear, because like I said, my blush, let me just even these out because I am gonna go out, so maybe I won't look like a crazy person. So like I was saying, the true key here for me is gonna be how they last, because it's hard to talk in blush. Do you ever realize that? Like, I can't really talk and apply blush. It's weird. But the whole thing for me is gonna be, does this last? Because my blushes come off very easy and I would really like one to last all day. So I'm probably not gonna do a check-in later because I have dinner plans tonight, but I will let you know below if these do last all day. I know these are super hyped up, so I'm really hoping they're gonna last. They look really pretty. I like the finish of it. Now, they both look matte, but for some reason online, exposed is the only one that said matte. So I don't know if it like, if the sensual has like a little bit of sheen in it, but it really doesn't look like it to me. I will update you guys below and let you know if it lasts all day. Otherwise, you guys let me know what you think about these blushes. Do you think they really do last 12 hours? I read a lot of reviews where people were saying they really liked it, but there are a lot of reviews in there that said they didn't think it lasted 12 hours. So granted, it's not very plausible to have makeup on for like 12 hours. I think like 8 hours is a good time. If this lasts more than like 2 hours for me, I think I would be happy. That's really how fast my blushes come off, even when I set them, when I layer them, all the works. And I'm really not a big fan of cream blushes. I just don't like how they rub onto my face. I just don't think I have the like patience for it. So anyway, I hope this was helpful to some of you. If you guys were considering purchasing the Tarte Amazonian Clay blushes, if you have any questions, as always, leave them below. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. It means the world to me. I post about 2 videos, sometimes 3 a week. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and I will hopefully see you in the next one. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye. Yeah, so what's up with my eyelash? Oh, it's just long, okay.